Hi there! Welcome to the SnapCode channel. Today, in this video, we're going to learn how to create an e-learning application with Flutter. Let's get started. Before we dive in, let me explain the folder structure. We have the Components folder, the Course folder, the Modules folder, the Routes folder, and of course, main.dart. Now, let's go to the Menus folder and open HomeView.dart. But before that, let's open PubSpec, YAML, and add several packages. We'll include Ionicons, Flutter SVG, Step Indicator, Cached Network Image, Transparent Image, INTL, and finally, Liquid Pull to Refresh. These packages will be used in the next steps. Now, let's go back to HomeView.dart and replace the scaffold's body. We'll also convert our stateless widget into a stateful widget. Then, let's create our app bar. We'll import Ionicons for the search icon, set the background color from the theme using a context extension, and align the title to the left. For the title, we'll use a text widget styled with the theme's title large. And for the action button, we'll add an icon button with the search icon. Next, let's create other components, like the calendar learn time widget. We'll add a nested scroll view with a header sliver builder and a body. Inside the header sliver builder, we'll use sliver padding and sliver to box adapter. Now, we need a learning card component as a global widget. So inside components, we'll create a new folder called cards and add learn card dart. We'll also import the SVG picture library and set up an asset manager. To do this, go to core. Create a folder named constants. Add an assets dart file. Here, we'll declare an abstract class for assets and a local class that contains asset paths. Don't forget to include this file as a part of the core. Back in the learn card component, we'll use the circular step progress indicator from the step progress indicator package. Inside the learning card, we'll add inkwell, a container for the calendar row, some text for learning info, and a circular step progress indicator. And then we try to create a TabBar component that contains several learning categories. First, we add variables for the tab items, which is a list of strings, and also a selected tab notifier, which is a value notifier. The default value is the first item in the tab list. It is recommended to use a value notifier here, but since it acts like a controller, we also need to dispose of it properly to optimize memory when running the application. Next, we create a local class or local component called HomeTabBar, which contains a string item, a current item variable, and an unchanged function that triggers when a tab is clicked. Inside this component, we use a list view to display the categories, and we add an animation controller to show some animation when a tab is clicked. Each tab will be wrapped with a center and a text widget, along with an indicator that shows whether the tab is active or not. We can change some parameters here to apply a different style. Then, we wrap everything inside a column and add this widget in a flexible way. Now, why do we use Value Listenable Builder? It's because we are using a value notifier instead of set state in a stateful widget. This way, we don't rebuild the entire screen, only the specific widget that listens to the value notifier. If you try to print the rebuild process, you'll see that only this part is rebuilt, not the whole screen. In contrast, if we use setState from the stateful widget, the rebuild will start from the main builder, which is not optimal. So, to optimize performance and memory usage, we use Value Listenable Builder. Okay, we already have the app bar here. And now for the last part, we will add the learning card. We're going to add the home learning widget locally. But before that, let's prepare all of the dummy data for this project. We will use the learning dummy, which includes words as dummy data. Next, we create models. Inside the models folder, add a learning folder, and then add model files. Learning dart, which we will use in the next steps, and also sentence. Dart and word. Dart as additional models. The sentence model contains text and words, while word is its own model. After that, we import them. Now, we still need to create a video learning card as a global widget. Go to the Components folder, Cards. Create VideoCoreLearningCard.dart. Don't forget to set it as part of Components, Dart. At this point, you may still see some errors related to missing libraries. For example, Cached Network Image and Transparent Image are used when reloading images. They will show a transparent placeholder using FadeInImage. Next, you'll see extensions for build context. Open Build Context Extension Dart, where we define helpers for screen width and screen height using Media Query. We also need an integer extension for number formatting, which will use the Intel package. Import that library as well. The next global component is dot container. Add it here, then we also create a learning notifier. This notifier holds a list of learning items as a value, and we must remember to dispose it later. We also add a loadData function that loads data from the dummy JSON. The loadData function accepts a category parameter, meaning if a category is passed, it filters the data. If null, it loads all items. We also set recommend as the top default value. After that, we add a listener to the selected tab notifier, so that when we switch the tab bar, the learning data changes and updates the learning cards on the screen. In the end, we replace the widget with home learning list. After adding new packages, don't forget to restart the app. Otherwise, errors might remain. When you run it again, everything should work fine. We also add app pull refresh as a global component, but remember, it should be placed at the top of the body to work properly. Now, why do we use nested scroll view? Because I want to make some widgets stay fixed while scrolling. As you can see, the tab bar remains pinned to the top when we scroll the content. Inside home learning, we also use flexible, so the layout works properly. For the list view, we use clamping scroll physics. The reason is, on iOS, without it, scrolling will bounce oddly. But with clamping scroll physics, it looks smoother. Finally, let's fix the app bar theme. By default, the app bar changes its color while scrolling, which doesn't look good. So in main Dart, inside app theme, we set surface tint color to transparent in both light and dark themes. This way, the app bar color stays consistent. Also, currently the theme object is created as a normal variable, but since it's actually static, we can optimize it by making it static. All right, that's it. Thank you for watching. I hope this tutorial helps you in your development journey. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video with your friends. Good luck, and see you in the next one.